Good morning, guys. Welcome to our, you know, vodcast. It's been a while since we last talked, guys. So, yes, I missed you. Yeah, but today we're going to talk about, you know, Juan. We're going to talk about the many cancellations that's happening this year. So, by the way, Juan Apla, today is September 21. It's 2 weeks away from the opening of classes for the public school, which is October 5. So, 2 Mondays from now. I mean, yeah, after next week, the next Monday, open na ang mga public schools and kids are gonna, you know, go back to really kwan. I'm private actually na, but a lot of people by the way transfer sa public schools. Pero today we're gonna talk about, yeah, aside from na postpone ng classes, na cancels and in a way ang undas or the All Souls Day or All Saints Day na mga you know events na bawal where the government is banning people. I mean, especially at the end of October and early November, bawal ang mga tao mo adto sa cemeteries. That's a weird effect of the pandemic, guys. Imagine All Saints Day and All Souls Day are canceled. We're not allowed to go to the cemetery. Some people, you know, for sa uban, even in some cultures, importante kina to honor the dead, diba? But yes, due to the pandemic, they are gonna cancel. You know, they're not gonna allow people to flock to cemeteries on those days. And I think even now, they're gonna limit the people allowed to go to the cemeteries to 30%. So mana. So maybe if you are planning to visit your, you know, long lost loved ones na namatay na, you better go there now or early to honor them. Kay mauna. In a way, November 1 and November 2 is cancelled. So daghag na cancel ra na happenings. And so for many families ba, yeah, importante gid kay na murag dag every November 1 and November 2 is like a reunion. I mean, you visit the graves of your lolo, lola, uncles, aunties, or even some parents nila. Yes, the loved ones. So mana na it's the time na normally magkita-kita ang pamilya. Sa uban gali, yeah, na mangaon pa dito sa kuan, na uban, there was a time na katong na mas younger, tuog mi dito, uy, ni tangki, matuog mi dito sa binteryo. O, diba? So, pagkasuway mo, anak, na natuog mo sa binteryo, there was a time way back in the 90s, na matuog mi overnight. Some also to see, you know, you see a lot of friends. Normally, same break mo ng mga kanina time, unta. Then you can see your friends in the cemetery, some hang out. Yeah, some guests, mga pa, ilag mga new friends dito sa cemetery. But, muna, this year, wala na. It can't happen. It's not allowed. Sarado ang cemetery. Wow, can you imagine that? Can you imagine, like, isulti na sarado ang interior on November 1 and 2? Actually, it's from October 28 pagay to November 3. Basta, it's a long, it's a whole week na walay interior. Oh, so, grabe, no? So, this is one of the weird effects of the pandemic. Imagine, mga holidays. I don't know, basta i-cancel sa ng Christmas po, no? At nag-ibaw. Christmas, New Year, we don't know what's gonna happen because ingani ang mga tao. Ingani nakakuan ba? Of course, it's not really paranoia, but leaders are, you know, you have to think as a whole. So general population, magana imong i-think. If you're a leader, probably you really have to think the general welfare of everyone. Because imagine ko na ako mag-undas dere. Yes, I think we're one of the kanang kwan, when it comes to November 1 and November 2, I think sa whole world, I think we are one of the talagang mo moadto gid sa cemetery. It's not like as into mga cool kin sa mga Mexicano kanang nahimo nang sinilya is Coco, but yes, we honor our dead. We go there. I mean, we're a multicultural country. Atong mga Chinese, brothers and sisters also have their traditions, and they also go there. They even bring food, mga incense, and they're really kuan. They also honor the dead as pala ambulansya. So magpadaplenta. Murag kuan ba yun? Naka full suit tong ilang doctor or nurse na nag-accompany sa pasyente. Pero mauna, we always honor the dead. So kamo guys, do you honor the dead? How often do you go to the cemetery? Because some baya, they only visit the cemetery on November 1 or 2 or on that weekend. Some every weekend. Some, you know, at least once a month. So mana, it's a kwan. Depende sa na ninyo, but mana, most of us really visit sa November 1 and 2 sa Minterio or 2. So mana guys, so how do you react? Unsa yung instant reaction na nakuha na? We can't do that. I mean, nabay ubang traditionalist yun ha. So for them, it's going good. It can't be postponed. And I guess dakan, in a way, dakan mawadag income ha, kasi on that day, dakan ba sa nagkwarta. The flowers, kaya mamaligay buwa, kandila, tiglimpyo, cementerio, sa pa, mga mamaligay pagkaon, mga pare, mga pastor. Tagano eh. Tigya tayong mga incense. Kung sa lain pa, mga uy, daghan og bisik, mamaligig prutas, mapiktuhan. It's like i-cancel ang Valentine's Day, ba? Yan na yun, you know, unsay epekto sa mga kwan. So there's an economic downside anang cancellation, by the way. So, but we have to prioritize health, so we have to look at the other side also. Na we have to look at the health side, because grabe gina noon. We Filipinos, we go there, dumog gina mga minteryo, diba? Dumog yun, as in dumog, like at the entrance. So ano, magka saka ni ron sumin hitabo ron September 21, daghan mag police sa inaaron. So inaadri sa kampo. I don't know. Pero mao na ba dumog ba yun na guys, di ba? I'm bibo pagali in it's a in you know, in another way of describing it, in some people it's festive even. Yes, so daghan naghalin actually mga pizza, mga money, even kana mga maligig money ug tubig. So daghang mapiktuhan, pero mana, so dili gyud, we have to on the health side also, which is tungod kay dumog kay mga Pinoy ana, magdumog gyud ta, mag makuan gyud ang tungod dumog kaayo, daghan gyud kay magwan, the risk is there. Marabag, it's gonna be kuan lang. Takot pagani na. Kung naagyod takot, naginay takot. It could lead to, wala, ilang ganyan, mga second wave or onsa. Which is also, manasakto na i-balance na. Okay, tinood kung dili isad i-ban totally na lang, na people find ways to come in, then kahit pa paano ito, let's say delimit the entry, basig adto na noon sa kuan, di ba, sa entrance magdumog, magtapok, saan pa maglalis kay na ini-insert. Oh, pareha ng dito sa Manila Bay na white sand ng Manila Bay, di ba? Gidumog mangga na. Oh, gidumog, nag-away pa sa entrance kay naligi mang insert. So mana. So it's just I think naalang say naasay point ang side sad sa gobyerno na to ban it. Labi na sa areas na na taas kay kaso or continue ang community transmission like NCR ng Descuan, mga yes, mainly karang the periphery of Metro Manila plus karang ubang hotspots like Negros Occidental o guban pa or even Cebu in a way naghapoy risk kay na manghapoy new cases although it's not as many pero yes you have to look at it that way and hopefully musabot na lang ta na gibuhat lang yun na because we are in an extraordinary time lang yun na nanay pandemic o daghang pwede matakdan kung magtapok-tapok ta. So I hope makasabot ta. I hope we always keep that in mind na the virus is still there. The virus could affect anyone, anytime. And you know, one positive na person lang ngayon musood na Discord could really infect, you know, dozens of people if given the chance lang yun na marag-kumpiyansa ta. Especially kanang mga gathering, mass gatherings like undas na sometimes di kinamalikayan magsturya, magkaon-kaon. And there will be instances. Even gakos-gakos, muamin, there will be instances that we're gonna be defenseless. Kedi, you know, dili mag-mas, magtabi, mag, you know, magbeso-beso, angaon. So dili kwan. Dili yun. Sad ta magkumpiyansa. So what do you think, guys? Do you think tama lang na we ban it? Tama lang ba na whole week? One whole week. Wala tay bawal ba ito sa biterio? Yeah. If you have any ideas on sa how to make it better na to find balance between anang dua, let us know. If you totally agree with it, ingon sad. What's your opinion, guys? And thank you so much for joining this, you know, podcast about the the cancellation of the Undas or All Souls Day or All Saints Day weekend in 2020. Thank you so much for listening and, you know, abot na sa Tapadong. We're now here in F. Cabahog. The trip today, we passed by in Fuente, Mango Avenue, Ayala, and now we're here in F. Cabahog. Diretso na lang ta, going to the Mandaue Cebu border. So traffic was okay. Traffic was moderate, light to moderate. There were like little congestions lang dito sa kampo actually. I don't know, maybe there's a celebration, but yes, there are more cars, but not really kuan pa, digid samok, not as samok as usual, I mean, during the normal times, plus wala, you know, buses gyapon, no jeeps, taxis are allowed, and I think the checkpoints now are because we were early, wala pa kayo checking, or wala pa nagman, but I don't know, later, nanasad na. So always kuan, follow regulations, wear your masks, wash hands, face shields, by the way, if you're gonna ride public transportation or if you wanna enter some establishments like malls, face shields, some would require face shields. So ilag kalimot, hugas kamot perme, dayon avoid lang yun, avoid social distancing lang yun, dito magtapok-tapok and plus pana magdalang yun mong Q-pass or other documentations para makasulod or makalabang-labang or even magka-travel within Cebu City, because there are sometimes na mga checkpoints like in Capitol, in, you know, in Asapad has my Grand Con, dito's my Country Mall. So one lang, complete papers lang. And have a nice day, guys. Have a great weekend. And I'm glad na nagkatabi na sa ta. Thank you so much for joining me in this biyahe. And thanks for the chika-chika. Although solo rata ron, walay guest. But see you na sad, guys, on our next episodes. And thank you so much for all the support. Bye!